This place is called Brightlight. Mito lives close by. Let's see. Hug the ground if you like. The mountains don't care. With the world getting darker by the day, there's not much time left to save it. And even though you've just met, he feels you're bound to play a huge part in that. Claims to be a simple lamp maker, bringing light into the world as best he can. You've found your way through the darkness. You shine like the sun in the sky. But will you use that power to warm the world or burn it? Hopes you see how much good you can do with power like that, and how easy it is to let it drive you mad. No matter where your path takes you, though, it's important to remember where you came from. The past brightlights the present. Wonders if you know how much of an effect you've had upon the world. Your presence changes things like light changes darkness. Did you realize that when choosing where to shine? Says he can see that in the way you brighten everything up. So happy you know you're helping brighten the world. There's plenty of it that's still worth saving. Whatever happens to the world, you shone as bright as you could. That matters more than you know. Says you did the right thing in taking up with the Myriad. They buy lots of his lamps. That's a tribe that believes in the bright things in the world. It's clear you do. Nothing shines as bright as being right. Says he can see by the twinkle in your eyes that you're not here to talk about your allies. He assumes you are here to be enlightened. He can't blame you, as everything just feels dark and hopeless these days. There's something about you, like you're knit together. Your fate's connected. What you've said, he feels too. So, why not call him Me Too? He senses you're like the dayfly, living every day like it's your last, afraid that when night comes, it might be proved right. Believes no one is entirely dark. Even the worst have a spark of good in them. Mito says there's darkness in everyone's life. But as a lamp maker, he wants you to know there's light too. His goal in this dying world is to be like a flame fly, burning to light the way for others. And therefore, he still makes lamps. You look like you're in need of a special get-through-the-night lamp. But to make something like that, he'd need a flame fly. Says that's the kind of attitude that spreads light everywhere.
Love the glow of the light!
No! Down! Down! Oh.
All the way up! Crank that glow up to 11!
I'll make you glow!
Too late!
When you're in the mountains, everything seems so far away. Middle life. Thank you. key energy is all used up. Running low. You've used up all your key energy. Watch it. What a relief! It's starting to add up. Shot through. Mm-hmm. key. Itchy trigger finger. Out of juice. The mountains are beautiful, but so exposed. You lack key energy for that. You're hurt bad. Crack-a-doom. All fired up. So much damage. Bullseye. You're harmed. Sunset's on its way. This area is blazing hot. You'd better have something that'll keep you cool if you're going in. Blisterboo, known for its perfect temperature and atmosphere. Try again when you have some key energy. Are you scared yet? It's getting dark. Don't trip over what you can't see. You're bruised. Ready for battle again. Thank you. Breathe in that day shine. Says the tribe Sifu sent them here to help defend against the rival tribe that's been terrorizing their village. Isn't sure how long the village will last if it continues. As if the plague ruining the land and destroying the crops wasn't enough to bring the village to its knees already. Heard that even simple things like puttle pops, surf salad, muffin grass and wild pips have become nearly impossible to grow. The Sifu asked you to help, and that's what you must do. Says they've mostly heard good things about you. Figures the myriad would outshine the Netra in any fight. Says talking to you was interesting. The Sifu asked you to help, and that's what you must do. We'll be around when you return. No time to look back. Too busy moving on. Wood scrap. The one kind of scrap you could actually still find growing. That silo there is so tall. It's a mystery what they used to keep in it. Down to half your health. You've had better days. It's been a long night, but it's over soon.
Thank you.
smart foe would leave now. Feels like something's about to happen today. You have hours stretching before you. That's the leftover you're looking for. Be careful down here. Easy to get trapped. So different from the surface down here. Yuck! Biohazard. Sickening. Don't stop to rest. He says that's enough to get the Mecton functional. You'll have an engine, a fuel soaker, a gun, and a gathering net, but no armor, nor enough oxygen supply. He made a suction device, so the Mecton can use the black tar as an instant refuel. You can also use it to clear oily goo puddles, so you can pass and access hard-to-get-to areas. He's been working on another project for the Mecton, a cannon, but it needs ammunition, and by that he means the Scripps. He says if they're trained right, they'll turn into a distraction for the Jumbo Puff. The best way to find Scripps is to go talk to Moog. He knows the ins and outs of every breathing thing left alive after the apocalypse. Unfortunately, this means you'll have to venture farther out into the dead zone than Moog's camp on the steep depot. Once you find Moog, he'll be able to give you directions to where you'll find Scripps. Gizmo thinks he's a little peculiar, but very knowledgeable. He has the ins and outs of all monster and creature whereabouts.